I'm Michelle Carnley, and this is UZ News. Legendary broadcaster Lynn Toney, 83, of Gulf Breeze, died July 25th. After serving in the U.S. Army, Mr. Toney graduated from Emerson College in Boston with a Bachelor of Arts degree in speech and communication. While in Pensacola on vacation, he fell in love with the beaches and decided this would be his home. He spent a short time at WKRG Radio in Mobile and moved to Pensacola in 1954 when WEAR-TV went on the air. The Lynn Toney Show was on the air for 10 years, and then he began doing weather and news reports, followed by the Popcorn Theater. Lynn Toney was 83. Gulf Coast entertainer Conner Cagle, 67, passed away July 24th from lymphoma. Conner was an excellent golfer who eventually decided to pursue his passion for music. He excelled as a singer and piano player, making appearances on the Dick Clark Show and Johnny Carson. Whether he was on tour playing with such groups as the Four Tops or Spinners, or entertaining folks at home as a regular performer at the King's Inn, Conner never met someone who didn't become an instant friend. Conner Cagle was 67.
Darling, you're just unforgettable. That's what you are. Unforgettable. So near yet so far.
I've done everything in music, I believe. I've played Vegas. I've played all the big clubs in the country. I've had a wonderful, played with a lot of big bands, big rock and roll bands. I've had a lot of I've had some albums out and 45s out, tapes out.
I can feel the love that clings to me. How the thought of you does things to me. Never before someone been more.
You know, I had a 45 RPM record of yours from years and years ago, if I'm not mistaken. I looked all over the place. I wanted you to autograph it for me. Do you have any more of those left by any chance?
No, that was my buddy Raymond MacArthur. We did that on the Sunshine label back in, golly, I'd say 71, I guess. This time you gave me a mountain, and that was right after Frankie Lane had done it. And it went pretty good along the coast here. It went pretty good. It never went nationwide, but it was real good along the coast. And if anybody's got a copy of it, I'd love to have a copy of it because I don't have it.
Do you happen to have any other favorite local artists around town that you appreciate, other than Lucy?
Oh, well, of course, there's always my buddy Red Lane. There's Ronnie Miller. I mean, I had Ronnie when I was a kid at the King's Inn. Ronnie's a great talent. There's Jimmy Kennedy has a great band together. Cecil Strom, a lot of the older guys. I don't know a lot of the younger musicians, but Raymond MacArthur and Pat Hudson, guys that played with me years ago. But Red and Lucy, and of course Lucy's brothers, and I could go on and on. There's a lot of great talent in Pensacola. Of course, Larry Butler is a great friend of mine, and Larry's done just fantastic, as we all know. So Clayton Ivey, Barry Beckett, they're all up in Nashville and Muscle Shoals and different places, and they're just icons in the business now. So, but yes, Pensacola has a lot of talent.
He give up all his comforts. Last time, trying to hold on.